this with your weekend forecast after a wet, soggy day.
Yeah, that's one of the more unpredictable elements of these thunderstorms is where that rain is going to fall, and especially in low-lying areas, folks really need to be mindful of that. So as we say in the weather world, turn around, don't drown if you see water rising there on the roadways. Here's a quick look at what we can expect over the next 48 hours. A dry start to our Saturday. That's good news. At least we'll dry out after this afternoon, but then there's more storms back both Saturday and Sunday. Heavy rain at times. I want to reinforce that again. We could see heavy rainfall for some locations. Temperatures now in Birmingham, 78 degrees with that dew point sitting at 74. It's awfully muggy out there. We're looking at rain to our south, Greensboro back towards Marion and northern Perry County. And temperatures right now ranging anywhere between the low and mid 70s. We have 72 in Coleman, 78 in Birmingham, same with Alabaster, and 75 down in Clinton. It's going to be a mild night tonight, and those temperatures are expected to heat up again tomorrow, though. Today we hit 92. I don't expect that we may make it there tomorrow. The reason being, some early morning cloud cover may prevent a big spike in those temperatures. I think we'll start to trend a bit more seasonable through the week, and we could even see some locations struggle to climb out of the upper 80s. So we'll call it a cool down. Yeah, we'll take what we can get, I suppose. At least for now, we've had quite the string of hot days. Today marks the 20th day of the month with temperatures above average for August. And look at our temperatures early tomorrow morning, low to mid 70s, 71 to start off the day in Gadsden, 70 in Talladega, and we're looking at 76 down in Clinton. By 10 to 11 o'clock, we will stay pretty quiet, at least to your lunch hour, but by noon, we're already near 90. A couple of showers possible to our west, but I think more of the rain at 2 p.m. will be in North Mississippi. We'll begin to see those showers and storms become a bit more numerous late afternoon and early evening. And West Alabama, I think you could see a little bit more action in the rain today or tomorrow than you saw today. So we'll kind of trade off who saw the rain today versus who sees it tomorrow. It's no guarantee that you get it, but it's also no guarantee that you won't. So you might see it again. Temperatures by 6 p.m. in the mid to upper 80s there. Notice some rain cooled air too. And then notice we could see this rain last a little bit longer tomorrow night, even after sunset. But I think by midnight we'll see general clearing skies. Sunday morning, it's dry. So as you're getting off to church Sunday morning, no worries of needing that umbrella. But if you're heading out for lunch Sunday afternoon, you may want to carry the umbrella just in case. Spotty showers begin to develop at around 1 p.m. Temperatures on Sunday going to trend back just a bit. Upper 80s, 88 in Tuscaloosa, 87 in Moundville there on Sunday, and notice the scattered showers and storms. I'm going to call for a more random sporadic shower Sunday. I actually think Saturday will prove to have the more concentrated patches of rain. Sunday we'll just see some broken lines of wet weather again, kind of same time frame, early afternoon all the way through the evening hours. Let's track the tropics if we will. So right now, looking at our satellite and radar imagery, actually this is infrared, so it's showing the energy in the storm. We've got this area of low pressure just off the coast of Florida. Within the next 48 hours, there's a 70% chance of development. This could be our next named storm. That will be our fourth of the season. But remember, after August the 15th, that's when we generally see 85% of our tropical activity. Yes, we've had a quiet start to the year, but just because we've had a quiet start to the year doesn't necessarily mean we'll have a quiet finish. Hurricane season lasts until November 30th. Within the next 5 days, there's a 90% chance that this low will develop. And with that area of low pressure sliding up the coast of Florida and on into Georgia and the Carolinas, it's actually going to circulate a lot of that wet Atlantic air into Alabama. That's why our rain chances do remain a little on the high side. Doesn't mean every day is a washout. It just means we have a little bit more moisture injected into the atmosphere. That causes for a few more showers and storms. But notice we'll see the trend kind of going down just a bit by the middle of next week. But look at this. With the rain and the clouds, those afternoon highs remain in the 80s through Tuesday. And that is a look at your storm team 7-day forecast. Jack.